I'm Lena, I'm from the Hualien Toastmaster Club. I've met Jack before, so I think I can introduce him a little bit. He's a senior student from the National Tonghua University. And I believe he's majoring in...
Apto Electronica.
There you go. And he's also very good. I think every time I see him, he's always very energetic and very sporty. So I assume that he's very good with sports. And today he's going to deliver his feedback speech. And let's welcome Jack.
Okay, good evening everyone.
Good evening.
My name is Jack. And today I'm going to share all you guys that the experience I've been through in the California in the United States. When I was in the summer vacation, I go to the California for 10 days to have some fun things here. And after travel, after traveling to the California from the San Diego, the south of California, to the San Francisco, the north of the California, I learned mainly 2 points in this trip. The first thing is, things would never be completely seen by those who haven't done it. It means, actually, this is my first time to went far aboard from Taiwan, and I fly 12 hours to go through the Pacific Ocean and step onto the United States land. But before I start this travel, I feel really excited about this trip because I've never been there and I really want to be there to feel something, to feel some lifestyle of the how United States people live. But I found interesting things when I look back to my former statements. When I was on the flight, when I was almost landing to the north of America, which means United States, when I saw the land, I feel a little bit nervous and I feel, I can say, afraid of it, because I finally see the land that I really want to be there, but I never know what is it inside. I never know what kind of person that I will meet in there. I never know what people and what things that I will going to meet in the United States. I'm afraid of the future, but after all that, I go cross the airplane and I landed to the United States, those fears just disappeared. But before that, I didn't expect that I had understood afraid of the nervousness that I, when I landed on the United States. And the second thing for the thing that I haven't completely see through the thing is, the map in the United States is totally big. When you see, when you Google it on the Google map, you think that your locations, your determinations is, for example, 2 blocks from the street. You have to walk at least 5 minutes for only 2 blocks. But comparing to Taiwan, you only walk 2 minutes to 2 blocks. So it's a really difference. So when I check down my hostel from the airport to my living locations, I spent almost 2 hours to be there. It's far out of my expectations in my formal plan. Yeah, and the second main point that I learned from this trip is that accidents are always unpredictable, but valuable experience that we should face it with an optimistic attitude. Because accidents, we cannot predict it, and we cannot know where and when we going to miss this experience. So when we made this, we should face it with an optimistic attitude. And so before I start with this trip, I set myself a goal. That is, I plan with only a plan. Yes. Before I start my trip, I only said what kind of location and what things, what determinations am I going to be there. But I haven't planned any of the approaches and any of the methods to let me go through there. And before that, I never reserved any of the hostel. I never reserved any of the transportation tickets to make me be there successfully. So I want to add these ingredients as my uncertainty point to make this trip more like a life that we all got, that all of our people will face in the future. We never know what is the clear determination how we face in the future. So I want to set this trip just like in that way. And successfully, after 10 days, I arrived all of the places that I said in the first place, and I've been there in a safe way. And the second accident is the reason why I don't use my PowerPoint slide, because all of the data of my picture that I've taken in the United States is already broken in my disk. Yes, I take almost 1.7 gigabytes of the pictures, and I store it in my computer, and a few days later, when I came back to Taiwan, my computer just broken in some reason. So all of the pictures is already gone. I have no evidence to show all you guys what American people look like and what's the living style in the United States. Yeah, but I think even though that accidents happens in your life, this is still unpredictable, and it's still a very valuable experience that we have cherished in our own way. And when the bad things come to us, how can we face it with an optimistic attitude to face this problem and let us in a proper mood will be a success. Will be a really important thing that we have to face in our life. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeff, for my speech. Now we will write the feedback and then you can pass to me if you have finished.